Week 4 of the college football season was absolutely nuts. We had upsets, blowouts, and a whole lot more. There were a lot of takeaways from Saturday, but these were the 5 I wanted to talk about today. Before we get started with today's video, make sure to click that subscribe button if you're brand new to the channel. If you love college football, this is definitely the place for you. Mississippi State might be the most exciting team in the country in 2020. Now, anytime your head coach is Mike Leach, you're instantly one of the more entertaining teams in the nation. Now, add him to the SEC? Sign me up. Mike Leach had quite the introduction in the SEC this past weekend as his Mississippi State Bulldogs knocked off the defending national champion LSU Tigers on the road. A large part of that was due to the insane play of quarterback KJ Costello, a transfer quarterback from Stanford. He threw an SEC record 623 yards with 5 passing touchdowns. Now, I know he's not going to be doing that on a week-to-week basis, but with Mike Leach's air raid offense in the SEC, every week is likely going to be a high-scoring affair. The Bulldogs' top running back, Kylan Hill, only ran the ball 7 times, but he caught 8 passes for 160 yards. Mississippi State very well could be a team we all slept on this offseason. They only won 6 games last year, but they did have some close losses. Sure, it's only one game, and we might be overhyping them just a bit. But is there any other team you're going to want to watch more than the Bulldogs in 2020? As I mentioned, Mike Leach is arguably the most likable coach in all of college football, and who doesn't love watching a quarterback just light it up every weekend? One thing's for certain, I'm going to be watching every Mississippi State game in 2020. Let's stay on the topic of this game and switch things over to LSU. The LSU Tigers, they're not going to be the same team they were in 2019. After having arguably the greatest season in college football history, it looks like the Tigers could be in store for a major decline. Just like I said earlier with Mississippi State, it's only one game, but there are definitely some things to be concerned about with LSU this year. They lost a bunch this offseason, including their Heisman-winning quarterback Joe Burrow, along with offensive weapons Clyde Edwards-Helaire, Jamar Chase, Justin Jefferson, Thaddeus Moss, and a number of offensive linemen. They also lost a number of players on defense, including linebacker Patrick Queen and safety Grant Delpit. Their new quarterback Miles Brennan threw 46 times for 345 yards with 3 touchdowns and 2 interceptions. He wasn't awful by any means, but it definitely wasn't anything close to what we saw last year. They also lost their offensive coordinator and defensive coordinator, so it could take some time before they get things sorted out. However, with games remaining against Alabama, Florida, Auburn, and Texas A&M, there could be many more losses on the horizon for LSU. The Miami Hurricanes are a legit threat in the ACC. Before I get started, just know that Clemson is the best team in college football, and they're by far the best team in the ACC. But if there's going to be any team that gives them a fight this year, I think it's going to be the Miami Hurricanes, not Notre Dame. They're 3-0 this season, and their offense has looked better than it has in a long time. They dominated Florida State this weekend, defeating them by 42 points. So far on the season, Miami's averaging 43 points and 500 yards a game. Houston transfer quarterback De'Ara King looks like a Heisman Trophy candidate, as he's thrown for 750 yards and rushed for 150 yards with 7 total touchdowns. Cameron Harris has been arguably the best running back in the nation, rushing for over 300 yards with 5 touchdowns already. He's also averaging more than 8 yards a carry. This past Saturday marked the first time since 2013 that Miami has scored 45 or more points in back-to-back games. Now, like I said earlier, it's going to take a lot to try and take down Clemson, but like I said, if any team in the ACC is going to do it, I think it'll be the Miami Hurricanes. The Big 12 is an absolute mess. As a Sun Devils fan, I can wholeheartedly admit that the Pac-12 is the worst Power 5 conference out there. Well, that was the case until this year. That honor now goes to the Big 12. Oh boy, what an absolute mess. I guess I'll start at the top. Oklahoma. Yeah, your playoff hopes are likely gone. Sure, anything can happen this season, and they can still very well reach the college football playoff, but the Sooners will need a lot to go their way if they have any hopes of making it. For the second season in a row, they lost to Kansas State, this time at home. With under 3 minutes left in the third quarter, Oklahoma led by 3 touchdowns, and they blew it. Spencer Rattler threw 3 interceptions, and the Sooners simply didn't look like the better team. Here were the final 5 possessions from Oklahoma. Fumble, punt, 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 interception. Inexcusable. However, major props to Kansas State and their quarterback Skylar Thompson. He pulled off the upset for the second straight year as he rushed for 3 touchdowns and threw for over 300 yards. Now, that's amazing. So, props to you, Skylar Thompson. Staying in the Big 12, Texas Tech. Man, you guys were seriously up 15 with a few minutes left over Texas and blew it? Come on. Now, it was a great comeback from Texas, but they were outplayed for about 90% of that game. Again, the comeback was impressive, but I'm not going to get too excited about the Longhorns quite yet. And Texas Tech, I don't know what to make out of them. They likely should have lost to Houston Baptist a few weeks ago, and they nearly beat Texas, but blew that. So, Texas Tech, I don't even know what to say for you guys. Oklahoma State survived last week against Tulsa, and then pulled out an okay victory against West Virginia this week. But so far, I haven't been impressed with the Cowboys whatsoever. This was a team I said could make a potential run at winning the Big 12 and potentially make the College Football Playoff, and they haven't shown me anything that would convince me that they can. Chuba Hubbard really needs to step it up, as he has rushed for only 194 yards on 49 carries this year. Speaking of disappointments, how's it going, Iowa State? Now, they did squeak one out by 3 against TCU, but they almost fell to 0-2 on the season. This was another team that I was really high on and thought potentially could win the Big 12. Maybe they'll bounce back, but who knows? Brock Purdy is sure hoping he can bounce back. His draft stock has probably gone from mid to late first rounder to a mid-round pick in the course of only 2 weeks.
Look out, Purdy is... Whoa, what is he doing?
My final take is that we're in for a crazy college football season. If we can get more weeks like this past weekend, I think we're going to be due for something historic. With the limited practice, changed rosters, and little to no crowds in the stands, we may see more upsets than ever before. We've seen it already early on, but there have been a lot of upsets and close games that likely would not have happened in a normal college football season. Again, no need to get too excited after 1 week, but how can you not? 2007 is arguably the craziest and most exciting college football season in recent memory. Now, I'm not saying this season is going to be anything like that, but there's no reason to think that it can't be. Well, those are my 5 biggest takeaways from week 4 of the college football season. What were your guys' biggest takeaways? Drop a comment down below and let me know. I'll be posting my top 5 takeaways every week throughout the college football season, so make sure to click that subscribe button so you never miss a video. If you haven't already, please take a second and give this video a thumbs up. Not only does it really help this video, it helps the channel grow as well. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you all in my next video.